Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on setting up multiple time periods in Enterprise Planning Cloud. Enterprise Planning Cloud allows you to configure the time frame and granularity for every year in each business process. We'll go over the steps for configuring your planning frequency and enabling weekly planning in financials. By default, you can select to plan and forecast on a monthly, quarterly, or yearly basis. In financials, you can also select a weekly planning frequency. Weekly planning allows planners to plan and forecast at the weekly level. When enabled, you can also specify entity account combinations for this feature. In some cases where you need to set monthly and weekly planning in parallel, you can set some of your entities to use monthly planning and some entities to use weekly planning. For example, a retail company can have their corporate profit and loss planning done monthly, while their stores can plan at the weekly level. You can also set an entity to plan at the weekly level for specific accounts. Here are the calendar settings in my application. Planning and forecast preparation allows you to set the current fiscal year, period, and planned start year. And select one of the planning cycles for each year you want to plan or forecast. You can set to plan at a detailed level in the near future years, and plan at a high level for distant future years. Let's go to the Enable Features page. I'll enable weekly planning. Next, I'll specify how to map weeks to months based on the number of fiscal weeks in a month. Here are my options. When you enable and configure weekly planning, rules for calculating and analyzing weekly planning are created to convert months to weeks and to convert weeks to months. After the enable process completes, log off and log back on to see the changes. Notice that weekly planning options are now available. I'll complete the configuration process by selecting a different option for each year. I'll quickly load data and go to revenue planning to verify our changes. For more information on loading data in Enterprise Planning Cloud, visit the PBCS Help Center. Based on our period selections, the planning frequency for FY18 was set to monthly. For FY17, I can plan at the weekly level. For FY19, I can plan on a quarterly basis. For FY20, I can plan at the year level. Let's say you need to set weekly planning only for specific entities and accounts. On the Configure Financials page, open Weekly Configurations. I'll clear selections for entities which I want to use monthly planning instead of weekly planning. Next, I'll select accounts for the entities enabled for weekly planning. In this example, I'll enable weekly planning only for revenue accounts. Let's see how our changes are shown on revenue and expense forms. Because we customize the planning granularity for some entity and account combinations, we are able to plan for revenue at the weekly level for sales US and use monthly planning for revenue accounts in other entities. Similarly, we'll be planning on a monthly schedule for expense accounts for all entities. I'll show you how planning in multiple time periods is calculated and rolled up by running the required business rules. In this tutorial, you learned how to set up multiple time periods in Enterprise Planning Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.